So good morning, students. Already I have finished chapter 5 and I have given the question answers. So this is chapter 6 and your topic of the chapter is the early states from the history part. And your page number is 47. So let's start the explanation. But before starting the explanation, what we will means come to know about the after reading this chapter is about the sources of the Mahajanapadas, origin of the Mahajanapadas, 16 Mahajanapadas and their capital, life during the Mahajanapadas, Magath, okay, Magath, a monarchy, okay, case study we will do about the Vajji, a republic. This is what this was all about. We are going to learn about the chapter, in this chapter. In this chapter, before going to start, one more first step is given, is that find out the present day names of any two Mahajanapadas. You need to do what? You need to find out the present day of the two Janapadas. For example, the present day name of Mahajanapada is Kasi is Varanasi. You see, we know, you know the place Varanasi. Yes, Varanasi we know. This was a place of Janapada. Okay. Now find out more Janapadas. Okay. Like the similarly it is given in there. You can take the help of your internet also, right? So in India, now let's start the explanation. In India, the 6th century BCE, that is before Common Era, witnessed a transitions. Transition means you can write with the pencil, that is change. Transition means change, C-H-A-N-G-E, change. Okay. From the tribal kingdom to a larger political unit, which is consolidated to form Janapada and Mahajanapada. In India, in the 6th century, there is a big change came in the administration. What was the change? The formation of Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. Janapada is a small unit of the people. Like for example, you can say, suppose I live in Azad Nagar, right? You know everyone, I live in Azad Nagar. Some of you know, don't know also, but those who don't know, to them I'm saying, I live in Azad Nagar. There are lots of the people are living together in the Azad Nagar. Okay, Anisha's house is also Azad Nagar. So Tanvir's house is also in back of my Azad Nagar only. So we all the are what in the living in this one society. Okay. So in before time, this society will choose one leader. Okay. We'll give a vote and we'll choose a leader. That will be Janapada leader. Okay. Understood. Now Azad Nagar, then you can say Goilahati one, then Goilahati two. Okay. Then Dohati, then okay, Ichhapurhati. Okay. This all. Okay, we'll choose a one very leader, one means top leader. You can say this one as a, you know that means Hotro Adhikari. You know about Hotro Adhikari, right? You know about Hotro Adhikari. What is Hotro Adhikari is doing? Okay, what is the work of Hotro Adhikari? Hotro Adhikari maintains the laws and order in the what called the all the Hatis. Okay, all the Hatis. Hati means in the Barpeta is the village, the Gao area, right? Hati means the Gao area, the village areas. So the Hotro Adhikari has the right to maintain the laws and order. He has the power to take control over that places still now. Okay. How many Hatis are there? All these Hatis, one, he is the supreme leader. Okay. He will be giving the, means whatever he will be saying, that will be the, means the people of Hatis need to follow. Okay. So this is what, how the, means the people are ruling. So this is also like a Janapada and Mahajanapada, no? Yes or no? The system of vote, with the help of vote only, he has been formed. Maybe the earlier time, okay? May the earlier guru was there, Hotro Adhikari who was there. He chose that this, after me, this person should become the next Hotro Adhikari. So the, this is way, now also it is going on. Janapada is Mahajanapada. Yes. Now, next we will learn this transition was considered a turning point into the Indian history. This change was considered as a turning point because when the leader is chosen, when one person is leader, then everybody will have a one aim only for the development. Yes. Iron tool proved to the proved to be stronger and long lasting with the help of the these sturdy tools. Forest was well cleared for cultivation. The use of the iron tools like plowshare simplified cultivations and led to surplus production. Surplus production provided impetus to trade, leading to the growth of the towns and the cities. You see, when this iron came, okay, there's a lots of changes came. okay, before time, what was happening before time? It happened that the people was using hand and they were digging the lands. Okay, they were using the hand and digging the lands. As a result, when you use the hand to dig the land, okay, what will happen? You will get hurt. Yes, you will get hurt, and the digging also will not become. So people started using the plowshares, the different kinds of, you can say, weapons, okay, in order to dig the land. And the now the cultivation became very easy. Now the cultivation became very easy. Surplus production was then provided the impetus to trade, leading to the growth of the towns and the cities. As you see, when this production and activities increased, when people started to do the production, when their production and activities increased, now town came, cities came, okay, because people were started to send their cultivation from one place to another. You know that the state of Assam is good for cultivating rice, okay, is not good for cultivating wheat, whereas the Rajasthan, Bihar is good for cultivating wheat. For this reason, the people of Bihar, Rajasthan and UP, okay, eat chapati, that is roti, and we are eating rice, morning breakfast, afternoon, okay, and the evening also we are eating rice, whereas they are eating chapati, because it is easily available in their place. And it is easily, why we are eating rice? Because it is easily available in our place. We are doing the production. Even Assam, you know that we are producing the tea and it is very much famous in the world. We are selling this tea in the world. Okay, it has got great demand in the international market. Assam is also known as a tea states. Our state is also known as the tea states of the India. So you see that when this trade will come, then that time development also will come. Because with the help of the money which we'll get from by selling the tea, rice, we will do the development of the state. And this is done by whom? The leader. To whom we have given the power. Okay? By the system of vote. The Janapadas and the Mahajanapadas. Okay, the post-Vedic period saw the growth of the towns and the cities with the flourishing trade and commerce. This led to the establishment of the more organized political setup compared with the earlier tribes. Tribes were the earlier known as the Janas. You know, now came. What is tribes? Now tribes, like for example, the Bengali tribe, okay, the Assamese people together will be told as a tribe, okay. A group of the Assamese people will be called as a tribe. A group of the Bengali people will be called as a tribe. The group of the English people will be called as a tribe. These are the small, small Janas. And these Janas will choose a leader, which were called as a Janapadas. Okay. As these Janas grew in the size and power, now they are increasing. The number is also increasing. Day by day, their product means their population is increasing. This known as a Janapadas or the foothold of the tribe. The larger Janapadas were called Mahajanapadas. Later on, like you can say Bengali, then Bihari, then Bihari Janas, then Bengali Janas, then Assamese Janas. This together came and they will choose a leader from them. They are called as a Mahajanapada. Okay. Which are now also, this is the system of vote still present. Okay. This is the system of vote. Still present in here. Okay. Now sources. We will study about the sources. The Buddhist and the Jain literature give us information about the Janapadas and the Mahajanapadas. In fact, the Buddhist text Anguttara Nikaya mentioned the 16 Janapadas that came out during this period. Now the Buddhist, you know the Buddhist text, the written, the follower of the Lord Gautam Buddha has written some text, some books, okay. By reading that, we can come to know that during that time, 16 Mahajanapadas and Janapadas was from, okay. 16 Mahajanapadas was from, that is mentioned in their book, okay. That among them, the Anguttara and Nikaya mention, okay, about the 16 Janapada. Which book of the Buddhist mention about the 16 महाजनपदास, इट इज अंगुताड़ा निकाया. ओके, अंगुताड़ा निकाया. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द महाजनपदास. As we came to know about the sources of the Janapadas and Janapadas, we came to know those stories about the Mahajanapadas we will study. Okay, the Mahajanapadas during the Vedic period, tribal units or the Janas existed. These tribal units were led by the king or a Rajan. So, however, by the 6th century BCE, these tribal units became large, powerful, and acquired the status of Mahajanapadas. Gradually, North India was divided into 16 independent kingdoms or Mahajanapadas. Together, these 16 Mahajanapadas were known as Sodasa Mahajanapada. The out of the 16 Mahajanapadas, Kosala, Vatasa, Avanti, and Magad came in prominence, and Magad was known to be the most powerful out of the 16 Janapada. Now, you see, in here, in the short, I'll say you is that the name of the 16 Janapadas is mentioned in your book in the page number 48 and 49. The name of the Janapadas and their capital was there. The mention is mentioned in there. 16 names of the Janapadas and Mahajanapadas is mentioned. The Janapadas, the Mahajanapadas were the important trade center during that time, because it played a very important role. Lots of the people were staying together. And still, if you see the means the system of rule, the stories of the king, if you read, we are thinking that we are reading the rules of the king, but you are reading the rules of the Mahajanapadas. Yes, we are reading the rules of the Mahajanapadas. Okay. The Janapada together, there were 16 Janapadas came of that time. But you know that Magad Samrat, who was there, Magad Samrat was very powerful ruler during that time. When you study the means Sri Krishna's means Katha, okay, you will come to know about the Magad Samrat. Okay, Magad was the king of the Magad, was always like he was trying to take away the power of other kings by killing. Okay, by increasing his boundary, this way only the king became very powerful, by the hook or by the crook. Now, did the people choose that person to be king? No, he is fighting to be the king. He wants to be the king. This is forcefully. Yes or no? By forcefully they are becoming king. The people will not choose. Democracy will not come, but forcefully they will become the king. Now we will study about the political life, which is in the page number 49. Okay. We already know that the major changes were taking place in the approach of governing political units. The 6th century witnessed a transition from the small tribal units to Janapadas and Mahajanapadas, which were further classified as the monarchies and the republics. As we know about that, there were the system of small political units was coming. The system politics was coming now. Before time, politics was there. No, politics was not there. People were ruling by according to their own wish they were doing. There was no one to tell that, oh, you need to follow this order. Okay. But the Mahajanapadas and the Janapadas only came. Okay. The Mahajanapadas, that is the king, was giving order that whatever he will say, that will be the law. Okay. Now, like for example, Prime Minister is ruling. He can be termed as the Mahajanapada. Yes, the Prime Minister can be termed as a Mahajanapada. And the Chief Minister in our state can be termed as a Janapadas. You understood? In presently, if I say, okay, again I'm repeating. In presently, if I say, Chief Minister can be called as a Janapadas, or as a Prime Minister can be called as a Mahajanapada. Okay, so monarchies and the republics we are going to study. Okay, we are going to study about the monarchies and the republics. But before starting monarchies and the republics, there are only 2 minutes left. So I'll end my explanation here. Till then, take care. Thank you. Bye bye, everyone.